Hawkinson for another week. And John, you know that that feeling when you just all day long you're like, God, I'm forgetting something. I'm forgetting to do something at work, and then you leave work and you're like, hey, no, you know, I have all the bases covered. I didn't forget to do anything. And then all of a sudden it just hits you that you forgot to do something. You've been there, right?
I've been there almost every day.
I was just there 25 seconds ago. I told you I was going to have a new open this week.
Oh.
I got the new open put together. It'll be a surprise next week, I guess.
Okay.
Got it taken care of, Wednesday afternoon?
Is it going to be Bill Walton centric?
There will be some Bill Walton, some Samuel L. Jackson. So it's going to be completely different, but I got it all done, and then I forgot to actually bring it down here.
Yeah,
so.
That happens. That's like when I leave the house in the morning. I have to do inventory, you know, keys, wallet, all that kind of stuff every day. So
I see that you're wearing black, which is appropriate because it's been a week of mourning for you, being a Green Bay Packers fan.
It has, you know, and as you get older, your recovery time is usually it gets greater, you know, for like when you drink too much and stuff like that. But as far as sports goes, as you get older, when the team loses a big game, the recovery period's a little bit shorter than you were younger. So it's been almost a week now, so I'm in pretty good shape.
Not that way, though. Not that way. No, the way Green Bay lost, it's okay. It's actually, I would expect it to take probably till, I would say September for you to really get over it. I mean, and I know, because I've been there. I'm speaking of personal experience. Now, you do get, I guess, a little bit more accustomed to disappointment when it comes to cheering on your favorite sports team. Because let's face it, I mean, there's only one team that's going to win the Super Bowl every year. There's only one team that's really going to have a fan base that's ecstatic at the end of the season. But the way it happened, and I had it in 1999, 98, 99 season with the Vikings, and then 2009, early 2010 with the Vikings again in New Orleans with 12 men in the huddle. You know, in 98, 99, it was Gary Anderson, who was perfect all year long, and then all of a sudden he misses wide right. They can't win the game, goes in OT, they lose. So I've been there before, and I know heartbreak, and the way that you guys lost that game, it does not get better soon.
Yeah, I mean, we were talking about before.
It's an open wound.
Before